Hello and welcome to this video, which is about setting up your lead management Excel sheet. So what you see on your screen right now is the dashboard view of the lead management sheet pro version. If you have downloaded this lead management sheet, either the pro version or the light version, this video is about how to set up a blank new lead tracking sheet. So what you see right now is the dashboard, the tables, the reports, and you have other sheets like the target sheet, the team performance sheet, the marketing sheet. And to be able to use this, you just need to spend about 5 minutes in setting it up for your organization. So if you've already downloaded the LMS Light or Pro, watch how to set it up. Or if you're about to start using the LMS, again, this video is for you. And the download link will be in the video description. So let me close this and let me open up a blank version of the lead management sheet pro version. This is a blank sheet. This is what you get when you download the lead management sheet pro version. So first you have the lead tracker. This is where we would enter the details of all the sales leads, and we would keep updating as the discussion progresses with each prospect till the closure stage. This is the dashboard sheet where you will get the primary reports, the monthly performance, the annual snapshot, the lead stage report and other tables. Then you have the monthly target achievement sheet. You have the team performance sheet and you have the dropdown sheet. And here is an important information, just something to know about before you start using. Once you've read this, you could either hide or you could delete this important information sheet, which you will not need going forward. Let's start about setting it up for your use. The first thing is you enter your organization name here. So let's say your organization name is Acme Corporation. So the first thing is you change your organization name here. Let me just zoom in the sheet a little to make it easy. So yes, the first step is you change the organization name. The second thing is you go to the lead tracker and you enter your currency here in the currency column, which is column R, the first sheet. So let's say you are from America, your currency is USD. So enter USD. Then when you go to the dashboard, the first thing is the date format in the lead tracker is in DDMMYYY. So that's how you need to enter the date. So if it is today's date, that is 8th of November, you would enter 08-11-2022 or 22. So that's the date format which we use. Now, suppose if you want to start using the lead tracking sheet from November onwards, let's say. So if November is the first month, in the first cell here for the month dashboard, which right now says April 22, you need to enter the first day of November. So it will be 01-11-2022. Or you could say 01-November-22. Both works. And then just do it once for all the other months. 01 Jan 23, 01 Feb 23. That's it. That's a one-time exercise. Or if you want to leave it as it is, if your financial year, like here in India, starts from April, you want it to be from April. So that's how it will be. June 22, July 22. So that's how it is. Enter the first day of the month that you want it to appear here. So if it is April 22, it will be 01 April 22. If you start from November, it will be 01 November 22. If you start in January, it will be 01 January 22 or 23. Just make that change once and your table is ready. Then you need to go ahead and you need to look at the drop-down options. So this is what will appear in your lead tracker. So here you have the lead source, referral, email, telecalling, website, social, PPC, pay-per-click ads, exhibition, offering, marketing, other and unknown. So we have about 10 drop-down options for lead source. If you want to change these, some businesses have different lead sources. So if you want to change this, go ahead and make the changes here. Or if you have more than 10, then you would need to go ahead and expand the validation list. So first you go to formulas and you go to the name manager. Here you have lead source, you click on edit. And if you see right now, it is from B4 to B13. If you want to add more than 10, then you need to expand. Or if you need fewer than 10 options, you need to reduce the list. That's how you can change the length of all the validation options. So customize the lead source if you want to. Otherwise, all these 10 options work for most businesses. Then lead status would be hot, warm, and cold. I'm not sure this would you need to change this, but if you do need to, you know how to do it. Lead stages, this is what I usually work with my clients. You have the database stage where you've identified a prospect that you need to connect with. You've not established a contact yet, that's into the database stage. Then once you've talked to the client or you receive a response, you move into contact established. Then you understand the scope, which is need identified. You submit a proposal, that's proposal presented. There may be some negotiations, hence the negotiation stage. Then you either win the deal or you lose the deal, or for some reason, the deal may be put on hold. So these are the existing predefined stages in the lead tracker. If you need to change this, go ahead and just change the drop-down options here. And your sales team, so if you're not a freelancer, if you are running a team where you have more than one person, add the names here. If you need more than three, add the names here and change the validation length as we just discussed a few seconds earlier. So your drop down is ready. Then you need to go ahead and you need to set your targets. So here again, you have your targets here. So go ahead and unprotect the sheet. Now here, if you see, the month is being picked up from the dashboard, which you had earlier edited. So no need to change the months in the monthly target column. Just go ahead and enter your sales targets. Let's say your target is about 100,000 each month. Just go ahead and enter. If it is different for different months, you could go ahead and change that. So in case if it is 100,000 for each month, your annual target is 1.2 million, and this would be reflected here in the dashboard sheet. So update the target, and that's it. You are done. This is what you need to do. First, you need to go ahead and update your organization name just to brand it for your company. Then you need to go ahead in the lead tracker and you need to update the currency that you deal in. The next stage is to go ahead and check the dates. From when do you want your dashboard to start reflecting your performance? If it is April, if it is January, or if it is from whatever month you download the sheet from. So enter the first day of each month to reflect the month in the dashboard. That will also get reflected in the monthly target sheet. And then you need to go ahead and update the drop down list, which is here. So that's it. That's what you need to do. And to be able to use the marketing sheet, which is another drop down add on, which we had added later on. So here again, the months are picked up from the dashboard sheet. You just need to go ahead and while you keep using, you need to add the monthly spends in your marketing sheet. That's something which you have to do going forward every month as you spend on your marketing campaigns. You need to keep adding your marketing spends in the marketing sheet, overall marketing spends and the marketing spends for each of your lead sources or marketing channels. So that's how you go ahead and you set up your lead management sheet pro version and the lead management sheet light version. The light version will not have the target and the team sheet, but it will have the dashboard, it will have the lead tracker, and it will have the drop down sheet. That's how easy it is. Just go ahead and change the option to suit your business requirements, be the date or be the drop down options, the currency. And you're all set to start using the lead management sheet Lite or the pro version. So go ahead if you have any questions, if you get stuck somewhere while setting it up, or even while using it, to send me a message. I'll leave my website contact link in the description. Go ahead and do that. I usually reply within the first few hours itself. So thank you for downloading the lead management tracking sheet. Do share your feedback, do share suggestions, and any questions, I'll be happy to answer them. So see you in my other videos. Take care and be safe.